Okay, hi, good day. So this is Joseph Panerio. So let's discuss about P-Core. So, but before we talk about P-Core, check muna natin analysis before about it, no? So, BPI, last February, shared about their technical analysis regarding P-Core. They said that P-Core may be due for a rally after breaking its near term downtrend term. So initial target is its resistance at 10.64. So yun yung resistance ng pinlat nila. So okay, and we may have seen a possible end of a downtrend. So sabi ni BPI trade, check that the stock has just broken above the near and downward sloping resistance that connects its peak to December on December 29 and January 20. So okay, so in short, BPI trade has outlook na mag-reverse na si P-Core. So okay, so tingnan din natin yung sa side naman ni this is the most recent. First Metro naman. So si First Metro, sabi niya, the worst is over. Now the worst daw yung sa, sabi niya sa the worst is over is crude oil price volatility has been relatively more manageable year to date. So yun yung sa global market. So ngayon, tingnan naman natin how oil indices from UK and US move, no, recently. So ngayon, what you see here is yung sa UK oil or your crude oil yung sa Brent sa UK UK side, UK index. So ngayon, there is a breakout here. This is what I personally plotted, the resistance. So may breakout tayo dyan. There's a consolidation dito. So let's observe how it works. But looking at the simple moving averages, setting ko pala on a simple moving averages is faster siya. So 3 days, 12 days and 32 days. So if we look at on a month perspective, on a moving average sa price niya, there's already a breakout here. Now, yung 32 day, yan yung blue. So nag-breakout na siya diyan. And meron that's the signal din, no? But we have a signal din dito, yung moving 3-day moving average and 12 days moving average, there's already a crossover din dito. So yun, may breakout tayo dyan. So tingnan naman natin yung US side. Sa US side ganun din. So way back last December, I plotted this resistance. And ito din, resistance dito. So this could serve as my immediate resistance. When it was broken, this already serves as resistance. When it was broken dito na part, this already serves as our immediate support. And this is our immediate resistance. Yeah, it break out pero hindi siya nag-sustain dito, no? So bumaba siya and bumaba din siya sa support, na break din niya yung kumbaga bumaba din siya beyond sa support, so it rallies south, no, pababa pa siya, so naging bearish siya at that moment. Pero pagdating niya dito sa part na yan, there was a potential reversal, and this long candlestick signal that there is something on the US oil in, no? So dito may breakout dito, and yeah, merong ito nagbumawi lang. Tapos dito, this is our first signal, no, sa potential reversal, and ito nag crossover yung 3-day over 12 days moving average. So this is could be my second signal, then followed by here, no, breakout siya on this support ulit. So na breakout na niya yung resistance. So na breakout niya yung resistance yan, and meron tayong signal niya dito sa crossover. The same with dito, yung 12 day moving average, it's crossover sa 32 day moving average and it rallies north, no, naging bully siya on this, naging bullish rally siya. So this is the scenario sa global market, US and UK, no. Kaya maybe that's the reason why the yung sinabi ni First Metrosec na the worst is over. Crude oil price volatility has been relatively manageable year to date. So yung market price niya manageable naman siya. So hindi natuloy yung babagsak pa siya going south, yung kumbaga magmura pa yung oil sa US, no? Because US was a factor din bakit nagmura yung oil, kasi mataas lang yung supply nila, so they have to lower down the cost, no. So okay, tingnan naman natin si PCOR on the Philippine settings. So why PCOR? Kasi si PCOR lang yung fina-follow ko in terms sa oil. So there's a lot of oil naman that you can check. So I think TA, Trans-Asia Petroleum something, oil din siya. So pwede natin tingnan, okay. So you can Trans-Asia TA Petroleum, so Tapet, pero I'm not sure about it. So pwede niyo siyang tingnan. So but anyway, let's look lang on PCOR. This is what I monitored, no. So sa PCOR, what I plotted here are this blue line dito is the support, and this gray area is our resistance. This together with this red line dito, slope red line. So meron tayong descending triangle na formation, no. But let's look at here. If PCOR will break this resistance, so there could be something here. So there could be a potential din na this long candle could be a signal, first signal, no, of the potential reversal. Pero hindi pa siya, though it's a strong push, pero looking at the two candles na sumunod sa kanya, it seems na nag-consolidate muna siya. Pero let's take a look how the 3-day moving average, merong potential crossover dito. So there could be something as well. So let's wait how the 3-day moving average crossover the 32-day moving average. The same settings that I use, 32-day moving average yung blue line, red line is the 3-day moving average, and the purple one is the 3-day moving average. So, and if price will break here at this level, so there's a potential here for PCOR. So, first signal meron na tayo, the second signal wala pa. Okay? So, okay, that's all for PCOR, and thank you for following me. And thank you for supporting our website, no? josephpanier.com. Okay, bye-bye.